Screen TV, brought to you by TCU Financial Group. We'll help get you there.
Coach, can you confirm if it's a torn ACL for Jock Sanderson?
Miracle, no torn ACL, just a severely hyperextended knee.
So is how long is that going to be?
It'll be a while. You know, there's still, I don't want to use the word damage, there's still some bruising and different things and maybe a strain or two of different ligaments, but it's not torn.
Is the season done?
I really say it's up to his knee. You know, we get a playoff run, there's a possibility. But, you know, if you just look over the next 5 weeks, I wouldn't expect him back for the next five. But it's not torn.
Brandon West is a guy that almost ran a similar style of play last year for this team. So I guess not lucky, but to have a guy like him just step in, what does that mean for this team?
It's a positive. Like I said, you know, we kept those backs, and he's been Brandon's been focused, and he's ready to go.
All winter long, he probably heard that he was going to be the guy. How did he handle not being the guy once he was told?
I think that's tough, you know. But like I said, he never heard it from me. So, you know, the biggest thing is, you know, it's where you're listening. And this football game has to be played. And I think that that's a lesson learned from him, that you have to make sure that you're on your P's and Q's all the time. And I think this is his opportunity to come back and play. And I think he'll do a good job.
Is he as effective a receiver out of the backfield as Jock is?
He actually, they're two different style players. But Brandon West is a pretty good receiver out of the backfield. And we saw that today, that he can even line up. Over the past couple of weeks, he's lined up as a true receiver. And that's something we experimented with, because he's pretty good with his hands.
How would Jock Sanders changed your offense, or what effect had he had on it?
I mean, he had his packages, and I think, you know, Brandon have his packages, Greg Carr have his packages. We just have to evolve again, you know, from, you know, we'll do some of the things that we did with Jock, with Brandon, but like I said, there are two different style receivers or tailbacks, but, you know, we just have to evolve as we go along.
Brandon felt that he lost his job because of his inability to hold on to the football. Has he got to be more focused?
Well, that's a part of it. You know, any of those guys that carry the ball, if they lose it enough, then they know that their job is in jeopardy. And I think he's done a good job throughout practice and different things of holding on to the ball.
Those guys you added today to the practice roster, are they considerations for this year, or are they strictly being looked at for training camp next year?
Oh, no. If the one thing I tell you about us is we bring guys in, it's to get them ready. And I've already talked to the coaches, and I said, let's make sure that we grow these guys up, because we may have to use them. And that's just, you know, that way we always build our depth.
What do you like about John Ash?
Well, he's a big, tall guy. You know, he's a big, tall guy. I didn't get a chance to evaluate him much today, but he's a guy that I remember we had in Calgary, and Sweet used to talk about him, and we graded him coming out. So I'm very familiar with his name.
Does Kenny Rowe have a bit of an edge maybe because he's been in the system and been in this team?
Kenny Rowe is a name that Brendan and I bounced around for a long time in trying to get back here. And I think he ended up in camp with the 49ers for a while. So earlier in the year, we looked at bringing him back. And it was just a good time to bring him back. And I hope to see Kenny do some good things and possibly stick.
Do you have injury updates on Hawkins and Sholden?
Sholo, he's progressing with his shoulder. And Hawkins, he's riding a bike and doing things like that. We thought he was going to practice today, but it was a little cold, so we didn't see him. But he'll be back soon. Hawkins should be practicing tomorrow.
Are you surprised to see Milt Collins out there after that hit with Bruce?
You know, it was just, I think, a stinger. So, you know, it's not like he had a concussion or anything, just a stinger. And, you know, Milt's a pretty tough guy. I've seen him, you know, go through a lot of things. So I'm happy to have him out there.
Can he possibly play this week?
Yeah, it's a possibility that he'll play. It's just depending on how many guys we look at putting on the roster and how we shape the roster.
Darian went in a couple of times to take advantage of the heater in there. How important is it for him with this weather to take care of that hip?
You know, he's not running anyway, so but you know, anytime there's cold weather and you have aches and bruises, you still have to take care of it. But I think the biggest thing is him just make sure his hands are ready to go for practice.